In this section, we'll take a look at female reproductive pathology, and our focus shall be the uterus. Let's begin with the normal uterus, and in this illustration, you'll notice the following. Down at the bottom, we have completed our discussion of the vulva and its relevant pathologies. We then moved into the vagina, and with the vagina, we looked at certain disorders, including our vaginal canal pathologies and cancers. Then from the vagina, we then moved into the cervix, and with the cervix, we talked about here once again, HPV being a major component of high strain leading into perhaps cervical epithelial neoplasia and eventually cervical cancer. We looked at sexually transmitted infections and those organisms that were relevant for you. And during that time, we also had referred to what may then happen to the fallopian tube. Well, between the cervix and the fallopian tube, of course, is an important structure called the uterus. Now, with the uterus, keep in mind that the inner aspect or the inner lining of a uterus, of course, is called the endometrium. That'll become really important for us because at some point we'll talk about endometritis, endometriosis, and then the superficial layer here that we'll pay attention to will be the myometrium. I want you to pay attention to the wall of the uterus. There's every possibility that you might have a young African-American female who then develops a benign tumor of it. And this, of course, I'm referring to being your fibroids or leiomyoma. Let's take a look at the uterus in greater detail.